Welcome back. So today I'm looking at Steve McQueen's anthology series, Small Axe, specifically Lover's Rock. And I can only judge a movie by the way it makes me feel. And this movie makes me feel great. I've been feeling kind of like, I'm not going to say down, but very uninspired. And I've been watching this movie like quite a bit. And again, I can only go off how a movie feels. And this is the type of movie you watch if you're kind of in a weird place, you know, you're kind of rewatching the same things over and over again. You don't really feel like watching anything. I think we all have TV fatigue. And, you know, just grab a kind of a bottle or have a drink and just chill out maybe after work. Like, watch this movie when you're in no rush and, you know, you just want to chill out. Like, this movie will help you chill out. So what is Lover's Rock? Again, it is a movie, part of Steve McQueen's anthology series. Steve McQueen, for those of you who don't know, directed Shame. So that was how I was introduced to him. And that is like one of my favorite movies ever. But for, I guess, the mainstream audiences, it would be like 12 Years a Slave. And so I've been kind of watching him for quite some time. And every movie in this anthology series has been great. So if you're, I recommend you go on Amazon Prime if you have it and just kind of watch all of them. They're not connected. They're entirely different movies about different topics. But Lover's Rock is for me the best one so far. And so it literally takes place over the course of a single evening at a house party. The name Lover's Rock is taken from a style of reggae music, which is supposed to be like very romantic in nature. And the simplicity of this movie is why I keep watching it. First of all, I miss going out. I miss social interactions. And the way the movie is divided, it's like we watch them get dressed, we watch them go to the party, and then we watch them go home. And the way he kind of transitions from like one to the next is like perfection, right? So the movie starts off, they're getting dressed. And I had such nostalgia, like I miss getting dressed and the excitement of getting dressed. Like I think when you go out, like you guys let me know, there's always like this expectation, like, oh, tonight's gonna be the best night of my life. And oftentimes it's like a mediocre night, but you keep going out because you keep hoping that it will be a great night, even though you know damn well like nothing's gonna happen. So they're getting dressed, they're looking cute. And I think the thing about going out, especially if you're in that mindset, is that like you're dressed well and your heart is open, right? So you're watching them get dressed and you're watching them get on the bus and they're so excited and they're kind of sneaking out of their house. And I can relate to this, right? You're kind of risking it all and you're like, will this be worth it? So everything, like it's like from the getting dressed to, and I think this movie hits differently, especially since we're not going to be going to house parties for a very long time, let alone parties. And so they get to this evening, and the simplicity of this movie, again, it takes place over the course of this night, and you kind of feel it. It's like literally set at a house party and all the different sort of experiences that people have at this house party. And it's really interesting because somebody could be having like the best night of their life, and on the flip side, other people could be having like the worst night of their life. The reason I keep like rewatching this movie like at an abnormal amount of times is it kind of builds up to this one scene, and this build up is why I'm watching it, because the first time you watch this movie, you don't know what you're watching, but you're kind of in awe. But when it hits, it really hits. So the way he's able to articulate connectivity, like that's what this movie's about for me, like human connections, is just perfect. Like there's a scene where everything's in like perfect harmony and everybody's in sync. And everybody just kind of lets go and they're not thinking, they're just doing. And that's why you go out, right? Like you kind of hope for these moments. And like I've had moments where it's like, this is the best night of my life. Like, I don't know why. You're just so out of your own head. Like, you know, out of your head into your body. And you're with all these people and you're all feeling the same thing and you don't know why. And the reality is, it's like, will you ever see these people again? No. You know what I mean? Will you ever like encounter any of that? No. Will you be dressed the way you? No. But it just like, I don't know, maybe it hits different because of the times that we're in, but the way it came together and the way it just like, it was just so special of a moment. And you pray for those types of moments, right? Like you pray for a moment where you're just like, everything makes sense and I'm exactly where I should be. And I think that's why I really love this movie. So you'll know when you get to that scene, and I'll kind of sneak up on you because first it keeps going and then you're like, I felt every minute of that. And again, I miss parties. I miss like people and not worrying about things. Like there's so many things in this movie, right? Like even just like they're like sharing bathrooms and people are waiting in line and you're all in a room down. Like this, we cannot do this now. So it just hits different, to be honest. And the transition again, so we get to this house party, a lot of different things are going on, right? Like some people are having the best night of their lives and some people are having like the worst night of their night. They're not having any connection. And it's really interesting in terms of expectations, right? Like people go in and they go out with such expectations. And as the night goes on, like some people get frustrated, some people just kind of let it go, some people get tired and they want to go home. And the different characters in this house party are very realistic, right? Like you got the creeps at the back waiting for the girl who's kind of drunk. You got people like grinding on each other, like they found the one they're gonna like kind of go home with and have a one night stand with. And then you maybe get like an actual human connection and like you find your soulmate, right? So the transition from like the party to the morning after in real life is like really depressing, to be honest. And the way he was able to kind of do it without being depressing is super interesting. And there's no like main characters in this film. Like people are just kind of, you're just literally watching people have a night out. You're kind of like a fly on the wall. It's through Martha and Franklin. So if there were main characters, it's the two that came together, right? So there's the ones that hooked up, the ones that had the worst night, and then the two that may have found like their soulmate. And so we kind of follow these two out of the party and into the cold, cruel world. And all this kind of connection and this moment of perfection kind of goes out the window, right? We get to the real world. They're kind of walking each other home. He's showing her where she works. Of course, like this is London in the 80s and there's a lot of racism. And, you know, like quickly you're kind of sprung into sobriety. And I love how we go from the party to, and I think the thing, like I'm kind of rambling, but the thing with these parties is that like nobody wants to go home alone, right? So through these two characters, they kind of go home together. And then the way he kind of separates these two without like severing their connection was also quite brilliant, right? Because there's like nothing sadder than like the walk of shame home where you're like, wow, like who was I that night? Instead, she kind of sneaks back into her room and she's able to kind of like get into bed before her mother calls her out for church. And this scene where this ending, again, this whole movie is just a party. It's like what happens on the night of the party, the amount of effort we put into like getting dressed and going out and kind of risking it all, right? So like this girl and her friend, they kind of sneak out of their house to go to this house party. They're dressed to the nines. And this one girl in particular had, you know, probably the best night of her life. And at the end, she's sneaking back into her room and she has this like smile on her face, like she risked it all, but it was like perfect. And I've had nights like that where you're like, you risked it all. You don't know if it was worth it. You don't know if the amount of money you spent getting dressed was worth it or the amount of energy, but, and then towards the end, you're like, this was worth it. And so she's just kind of smiling and the movie ends. So again, there's no drama in this movie. There's nothing. It really speaks to connectivity and just the human desire to like, just find people and chill, you know what I mean? Again, it's not about finding your soulmate or like any of this stuff. It's just about kind of putting yourself out there. And I think it's very rare that like as human beings, you kind of are in that mindset where you're not thinking too much. You're just kind of like accepting. And I think going out is an interesting thing because you go out with such high expectations. So your heart is open and you're dressed to the nines. So if you can kind of get everything to align, it can be the best night ever, or it can be the worst night ever, depending on what you're looking for. So again, like watch this movie when you're chilled out. This is the type of movie I would love to like stream with people and we could just chill out and watch it. And it changed my mood totally. And it's been keeping me like super happy because I've been in this mood where I've been like watching the same things like over and over again. And so like I'm reluctant to start something new, even though I shouldn't. I have a whole ass channel saying that I should, but this movie will make you so happy. It'll make you feel so like complete. And again, out of all the movies in this anthology, this is by far my favorite. It's one of my favorite movies I've seen just in terms of the simplicity of it and the way he's able to capture how, like, there are moments in this movie where you're like, I totally get what you're doing. I totally get where you're coming from. And I love it. So you guys let me know what you think. Enjoy your weekend and I hope I made it a little bit better. Watch it, I promise you, like satisfaction guaranteed, like have a glass, just chill out. Like you don't need to go out, just stay home and this will make you feel like you went out. So that being said, I will catch you all later.